Monday. But weather-wise, going to be really nice today compared to the rest of the week. Sunshine back into the 70s. Looks like some rain, showers, thunder, all that stuff tomorrow. Dropping down into the mid-60s and then down into the 50s with more rain on Wednesday. And then finally, by this weekend, hopefully picking back up and heading back into the 60s.
I heard like in the 40s, 47 or something on Friday.
Yeah,
isn't that
chilly,
the deal?
Yeah. Chilly later this week, but it'll hopefully improve this weekend and get nice again. Not as nice as we had this past weekend, but boy. We got one more day of that, so make the most of it if you can today.
Quiet start today to what will be a strong wind and rain and storm day tomorrow.
Mm-hmm. Three ways with Shaw. We'll get to Bad News Happy Music, the Monday morning throwback. It's tax day, so we'll talk about some of that. Obviously, tax day, get your taxes in the mail if you haven't done that yet. A lot of places trying to offer up tax day deals, take advantage of the quote-unquote holiday, if you will. If you need something, you can get in touch with us by visiting rockmornings.com. Rockmornings.com for more info on how to get in touch with us. You can listen live on the website. You can also check out our daily podcast. We are going to be talking to a very special guest later on this morning as well. He's going to join us to talk about a big event that's happening in August right in our area. So more details on that a bit later on. If you need something, again, get in touch with us.
More of your Rock Mornings coming up in just a bit.
So, Mr. Scooter Man, did we scoot?
I did get it out of the storage this weekend. Yes, little, took it for a little ride.
Little
did
boot you? Scooting nice. Boogie, where'd you go?
Oh, I just took it from my buddy's house back home.
Oh, okay.
Didn't go too far.
You didn't go for a little pleasure cruise?
No, but got it cleaned up a little bit. It'd been sitting in a dusty garage all winter, so.
Yeah. Did she miss you?
She didn't say.
Have you named her? Didn't we talk about this? You're supposed to name her.
Yeah, I never did settle on a name, I guess.
Come on, man. You've had her for a year now.
Only got about 400 miles on it, so it's not like we've got a long relationship.
I know, but if you're planning on riding this thing all over Kingdom Come, you got to have a
name.
It's
just a scooter, Brian.
Yeah, but you still can put a name on it. It's okay.
Where does that get stored?
A friend of mine rents a neighbor's garage for one of his cars, and he's got some extra space in there, so I just tucked it in there for the winter.
So now, did you bring it to work today?
No, I didn't yet today, but
today would be a great day. Hey. Did you see the weather today?
I know, it's beautiful. It was gorgeous all weekend.
We went for a ride yesterday, and down here on the Cass Street Bridge, you know, you go we were at the red light, and it turns green, and you go through the intersection, and then you go up. Obviously on the bridge, and it's not a massive incline, but it's long. It's a long incline, and I, you know, of course, I'm on the Harley, and there's a couple of cars around me, and there's a poor son of a bitch on a scooter, and I've been that guy. I've been on a moped, so I know it's hills are not fun because you, even if you're going at your max speed on a 50cc scooter at 35 miles per hour, as soon as you start to incline,
you're
going
to lose.
You're going down to like 10 miles. You're lucky just to get up the hill, right?
Exactly.
You're just happy to get. And no one likes that guy. Everyone behind him is like, this idiot.
What are you doing on this road?
Right. And the speed limit actually is only like 30 miles an hour on the bridge. So it's not until you get over it onto the pike where it goes
to
45.
You're going to start slowing people down. Yeah.
Right. But like this poor guy, I got on the, I hit and I'm going up and I look at my rear view and this poor guy, he's like, yourself small and you're like, if I condense myself, maybe I'll weigh less and it'll go fat. No, this poor guy, he became a very small speck in my rear view mirror, Shaw.
We were driving home from seeing my mom this weekend, and so we took, it's called Highway 60, and it goes from Sauk City to Spring Green. It's a scenic byway in the state of Wisconsin, goes past Natural Bridge State Park, real pretty along the, anyway, so many motorcycles convertibles and, you know, nice rides that were out with the top down, and there were a lot of people that were taking in the scenery.
A lot of really cool classic cars on the road yesterday,
I agree.
A lot of that. Same situation today in terms of the weather. Going to be in the 70s, maybe not as warm as it was yesterday. Boy, it almost got like too warm yesterday.
Yeah, it felt like 80, I think, at one point.
I put the window AC in the bedroom, and we had it on the last two nights. Probably have it on again tonight. But sunshine and in the 70s today, and then
rain starts
like
tomorrow.
100% rain, showers, thunders, all that stuff.
Yeah, it could be some heavy rains tomorrow and into tomorrow night. Maybe 3/4 to an inch during the day tomorrow, another 3/4 to an inch overnight tomorrow night. So,
all right.
And
we're
going to get some rain.
Mostly afternoon into evening, maybe some hail, maybe some damaging winds. Those are threats, apparently. Western Wisconsin, the strong winds developing 20 to 35 miles an hour, gusts over 45 possible. Given the strong winds, And then also, like you said, Shaw, 1 to 2 inches with locally higher amounts possible when the heaviest rain falls. And again, that sounds like later tomorrow afternoon into tomorrow night.
Mm-hmm.
So there is that storm to
keep enjoy today.
Yes.
In World War III.
Yes.
Okay.
President Joe Biden is set to host Iraq's leader this week for talks that come as tensions across the Middle East have soared over the war in Gaza and Iran's attack on Israel in retaliation for an Israeli military strike against an Iranian facility in Syria. The sharp rise in security fears has raised further questions about the viability of the two-decade American military presence in Iraq. Iranian proxies there have launched attacks against U.S. interests throughout the region. Today's meeting between Biden and Iraq's prime minister will include a discussion of regional stability and future U.S. troop deployments, but will also focus on economic, trade, and energy issues. An Unalaska man faces charges for sex-related crimes as well as drug possession. Timothy Polubicki appeared in La Crosse County Court late last week. The 56-year-old Polubicki is accused of second-degree sexual assault of a child, use of a computer in a sex crime, and possession of meth. Polubicki is in the county jail under a cash bond of $5,000. He's due back in court on Friday. Polubicki's been ordered not to use the internet and is allowed no contact with anyone under the age of 18. A burning ban has been issued for the city of La Crosse as well as the town of Madera. And no sooner was that ban announced over the weekend than La Crosse firefighters were called out to a grass fire in Madera yesterday. Fire crews say high winds apparently spread the flames from a fire pit where a homeowner was burning garbage. About 2 acres of land were burned in the area of Deerfield Road, but no structures were damaged. The fire danger in the La Crosse area is likely to be at a very high level for the next couple of days. Wisconsin Governor Tony Evers says citizens often call on him and other state officials to fix the roads. The condition of highways around the Badger State is likely to be an issue in many elections this fall, including an area race for state Senate. Republican candidate Stacy Klein in the 32nd District tells WISM News that road repairs should be one of the easiest tasks to complete.
We're seeing a lot of areas where, you know, we need to be working on that. You know, people drive on them every day and are probably wondering where the heck do my tax dollars go. So we need to work on, you know, infrastructure.
Klein says some of the state's surplus, adding up to billions of dollars, should be used to finance needs such as road work around the state.
Yeah, they're definitely not fixing the roads.
Mm-hmm.
I don't care what anybody says. You drive around for 10 minutes and it's brutal. And that's on any street, any city. It doesn't matter where you go.
There's a large DMV project out in Westby. Holy moly.
Yeah.
All the way through town, basically. I'm assuming widening the road, taking down a bunch of trees along the same kind of... It feels like the same thing that they did on South Avenue in La Crosse this past year, like a big DMV project. Saw a bunch of those started yesterday on our way, on our travels back and forth towards Madison, yeah.
Three-way with Shaw in the newsroom. We got the Monday morning throwback coming up. Also, a very special guest is going to join us later on to talk about a big event that's happening in August in our area, Shaw. We'll do that sometime after 7 o'clock. We've also got a text right now from Selective Hearing Stew. Well, that looks delicious, Shaw. He's got something on the smoker.
Yeah?
10 pounds of bacon that he cured for 8 days and then smoked for 5 hours yesterday. One pepper, one maple brown sugar.
Dude, I wonder if that guy lives in my neighborhood. Because I woke up yesterday, it's like, when your neighbor's smoking meat, everybody knows. Meat. Because I was like, oh my gosh, it's like 7 o'clock in the morning and it was already smelled delicious.
Well, Stu, your picture does nothing for me at all. I don't know why you're not just dropping some of that off here at the radio station. That'd be a lot better use of your time than sending us pictures and text messages.
Thank you.
No. No, thank you. I want some of that actual meat here in the studio. Godsmack in a couple of minutes. Right now, it's from Ashes to New.
Rock Mornings. On air. Online. On the app.
Rock Mornings with Brian and Gene. That is Godsmack. Whatever. Bucks. Not good. Not very good at all.
I thought we were done, and then we were waiting to find out what the playoff situation was.
They lost to the Oklahoma City Thunder on Friday, 125-107. Then they lost to the Magic yesterday, 113-88. In their regular season finale, they lost 8 of their last 11 into the playoffs. It is not good right now in Milwaukee. They fell out of second place in the East with the loss to the Magic and the Knicks win over the Bulls yesterday, so they've got the number 3 seed. They'll take on number 6, Indiana. That game 1 of that series is on Sunday for the Bucks. Obviously, there's a play-in tournament to determine who else gets into the playoffs in the East and the West, but Milwaukee's series against Indiana is set. Game 1 is on Sunday.
Okay.
Couple days off.
Game 1 is on Sunday.
Give Giannis
Sunday.
More rest on that strained calf muscle that he's got. And, yeah, game 1 on Sunday. Brewers beat the Orioles on Friday 11-1. Then they beat them 11-5 on Saturday, but they lost 6-4 in the series finale yesterday. Brew Crew at home for the first of three against San Diego. First pitch tonight is at 6:40. Scotty Scheffler carded a 4-under-68 over the final 18 holes at the Masters yesterday to finish at 11-under. For the tournament, beat Sweden's Ludvig Åberg. I think that's how you say his last name. By four strokes. Tiger Woods, by the way, not good. Shot a 77 on Saturday. On Sunday, finishing 16 over par for the tournament. His cumulative 304 was the highest 72-hole score in his professional career, left him in last place among those who made the weekend cut.
Yep.
Yeah, he made the cut. That's great. But, boy, is he not, he's not good at golf.
Congratulations to Scotty.
Yeah, two-time Masters. Yep. Chase Elliott pulled ahead and cleared Ross Chastain on the first lap of the second restart in overtime yesterday at Texas Motor Speedway, ending a 42-race winless streak for Chase Elliott. It was the fifth win this season for Hendrick Motorsports, 306 for NASCAR's winningest team overall, but it's the first one for Chase Elliott in the number 9 Chevrolet since Talladega in October of 2022. So it's been a while since he was in victory lane. And UFC 300 over the weekend, Pereira over Jamal Hill in the first round to retain the light heavyweight belt. You had Kayla Harrison defeating Holly Holm with a rear naked choke in the second round of her UFC debut. She looks impressive.
Yeah.
Very impressive.
Okay.
And Conor McGregor apparently is actually going to get into the octagon again. 170-pound return to action for Conor McGregor against Michael Chandler. This will be a 5-round main event of UFC 303. I believe it happens in June. This was announced during the UFC 300 post-fight press conference on Saturday night. So, there you go.
Mm.
Rock Mornings with Brian and Gene. Monday morning throwback coming up. Get in touch with us. Visit rockmornings.com.
Rock Mornings with Brian, Gene, and Shaw.
This spring, the beloved series returns. ABC proudly presents The Goldener Bachelor. Join Jerry as he embarks on a journey of love, life, and laughter to find his soulmate again. It's an unforgettable adventure that ends on a scenic beach locale when he kneels to say,
I love you 1,000%.
Again.
I'm never going to stop believing that every day I choose you.
Again.
Will you marry me?
Again. Whether you want to create new memories or rekindle old ones, since they just happened 90 days ago, don't miss The Goldener Bachelor, because love is eternal, unless you find it on a TV show. Again.
Go figure. It didn't last. True love is dead.
It's over.
If you can't be old and find old love on television with another old person, then what the hell? What the hell hope does anybody else have?
So the 50% American divorce rate happened. Is that what's?
Yeah, they announced it on Friday on Good Morning America. Now, obviously, I didn't watch any of the Golden Bachelor, but it was funny to hear the recaps as this old guy was banging all these older broads. 3 months of marriage, and they're getting divorced already. Jerry Turner and Teresa Nist not lasting more than 3 months.
Boy, I think you're any kind of that's not even long enough for anything to matter.
They didn't give any real details. We did find out, though, there was like that expose, I think, where they said that he kind of lied about not dating after his wife died, and that was apparently not the case.
That's not even a full season.
She did say that it had nothing to do with the fact that he lied about not dating anyone else since his wife died. Jerry said, quote, we've come to the conclusion mutually that it's probably time for us to dissolve our marriage. I root for her every day. We just feel like it's the best for the happiness of each of us to live apart.
Yeah, we were doing this solo single thing, and that's way better than whatever this thing is.
Well,
we're doing
right guess now. She didn't want to give up her job. She lives and works in New Jersey, and he lives in Indiana and South Carolina, I guess. And so they were trying to, like, figure it out, and it didn't work, and again, isn't that something you figure out before you get married?
I don't know. If they were on a TV show that brought them together and all this.
I'm shocked to find out that true love doesn't manifest on television.
I am not getting rid of my couch or dishes, okay? I'm not moving to Indiana.
Yeah,
I'm
fellas, take it from someone who knows. Now, it's been a long time, but don't put your stuff in storage. Trust me. Don't throw away your crap because you're moving in with her or she's moving in with you. Keep your stuff because you're going to need it. Put it in a storage locker.
I bet these people kept all their stuff.
Tonight on television, The Voice, part two of the knockouts on NBC. American Idol over on ABC, the top 14 being revealed tonight. So You Think You Can Dance on Fox and Deal or No Deal Island also on NBC. You've got All American, NCIS, and NCIS Hawaii On television, late night shows, Kimmel's got Seth Meyers, Riley Keough, and the Black Pumas. Stephen Colbert's talking to Salman Rushdie. Or Sal Bass, right?
Yeah.
Is that Sidra? Well, that's Salman. Yeah. Did you see any of the SNL highlights?
I saw the Caitlin Clark.
So Caitlin Clark popped up and was apparently very good. I haven't seen it yet, but I do want to watch this weekend because I like Ryan Gosling. I think he's funny. Chris Stapleton apparently performed and did really well. Annie also was in some skits or was in a skit and was apparently very funny. And they did a Beavis and Butthead skit.
I saw that one.
Which apparently they couldn't hold it together.
They could not hold it together.
So I got to watch SNL from this weekend. Apparently it was actually a pretty funny show.
Yeah, yeah.
I don't know if you watched it. Did you watch?
I did not catch it. Okay. I saw a little bit of the Caitlin Clark bit.
Yeah, I guess she threw some shade at Michael Che.
She did, yes.
Well, it was nice.
Women's basketball or women's sports.
Women's place being in the kitchen. And
yeah, yeah. All right.
She looked...
comfortable?
No. Nervous, I thought.
Oh, really?
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah. I mean, she did a great job, don't get me wrong, but she looked a little bit, like, out of her realm.
She said she was more nervous than she's ever been on a basketball
court. She looked
court.
Like it, too.
Wow, it's a different...
Oh, well, yeah, completely.
I mean, there's cameras and lights and people fluffing your hair and putting makeup on, and there's cue cards and all these people with headsets running around. And, you know, when you're on the basketball court, you can just kind of focus on the basketball, right, for the most part. But
I mean, she did a great job, and it was really, really funny and clever, but she looked like she was a little bit nervous.
Three-way with Shaw in the newsroom. What else is going on?
Israeli leaders are crediting an international military coalition with thwarting Iran's direct attack and calling the coordinated response a starting point for a strategic alliance of regional opposition to Tehran. But the Israel War Cabinet has met without any apparent decision on the next step as a nervous world waits for any sign of further escalation of the war. The military coalition is led by the United States, Britain, and France and appears to include a number of Middle Eastern countries. It shot down the vast majority of about 350 drones and missiles that Iran had launched overnight. 1 week into her campaign for a Western Wisconsin Senate seat, Stacey Klein is busy promoting several of her priority issues for the election. Klein is running for the Republican nomination for the seat now held by Democratic Senator Brad Papp. The Trempealeau County board member says people in her generation around the turn of the millennium have taken pride in helping others, and she wants those values applied in state government.
You know, you treated everyone really well, and so really want to fight to bring that back, because there's a lot of families that are hurting right now with the economy, and you know, we've got a surplus at our state level that could be turned back to the tax-paying citizen, and just want to fight for those things that make our country and make our state great.
Klein says Governor Tony Evers likes to veto bills passed by Republican lawmakers. She hopes to promote more bipartisanship in Madison. On this tax day, the IRS is promoting the customer service improvements the agency rolled out since receiving tens of billions of dollars in new funding through the Inflation Reduction Act. From cutting phone wait times to digitizing more documents and improving the Where's My Refund tool to show more account details in plain language, agency leadership is trying to bring attention to what's been done to repair the agency's image as an outdated and maligned tax collector. For most people, April 15th is the last day to submit tax returns or to file an extension. The IRS says it has received more than 100 million tax returns so far, with tens of millions more expected to be filed. And if you're feeling sleepy or tired and wish you could get some more shut-eye, you're not alone. A majority of Americans say they would feel better if they could just get more sleep, according to a new poll. But in the U.S., the practice of grinding and pulling yourself up by your own bootstraps is ubiquitous, both in the country's beginnings and our current environment of always-on technology and work hours. And getting enough sleep can seem like a dream. The new Gallup poll released today found 57% of Americans say they would feel better if they could get more sleep, while only 42% say they're getting as much sleep as they need. Younger women, those under the age of 50, were especially likely to report that they are not getting enough rest.
Yes. Raising kids.
Yep.
Never busy. Sleeping.
Naps. Need those naps, Shaw. Mm-hmm. Gotta take them. Gotta have them.
Get them while you can.
Not only is it tax day today, Shaw, it's also Jackie Robinson Day. Today was the day he broke the color barrier.
Okay.
And so all Major League Baseball players today will be wearing
42?
His number. Yep. Even though they retired it across the board, Mariano Rivera, the last one to wear it before it officially got retired. But everyone, I believe, today going to be wearing it. Red Sox started like 10 o'clock this
Patriots
morning.
Patriots Day, right?
Well, Patriots Day is on Friday, but today is Marathon Monday. Okay. So when they do the marathon in Boston, the oldest marathon in the country, they also have a early Red Sox game. They've been doing that for a long time now, so it's nice. I go home, and there's a baseball game on right at 10 o'clock. It's great. And it's my team. Yeah. So it's also McDonald's Day. Apparently today is the first day that the anniversary that Ray Kroc opened up his first McDonald's. So
you know what you should do today?
I don't know if they're doing specials, but
you should try a Big Mac.
There you go, Sean.
Oh, yeah, sure.
You've never had one. This is the day. Did you have lunch plans? There you go.
I haven't thought that far ahead, no.
Well, you're going to want, you're probably going to want to have them cut it in half or cut it in half when you get home because you're not going to be able to eat a whole Big Mac.
That's true, yeah.
Little guy like you can't handle a full Big Mac, Shaw. It's a lot of meat in there.
It is.
For a little guy.
Got to save room for those 8 french fries, you know.
Do you get a small fry when you go to McDonald's?
Mm-hmm.
In the little paper bag?
Yeah.
Just 2 fries for me, please. Well, enjoy your Big Mac. I hope you have one.
Someday.
Today's the day. Get your scooter out, ride to McDonald's, eat your Big Mac.
You could pull up in the parking lot, have it right there on your scooter. You got a little trunk lid. You could have, you know, spread out your fries, your ketchup and all that stuff. And
my table setting and all that.
Yes.
Yeah. McDonald's Day, Shaw. Have a Big Mac. Do we have a coupon? Can we get him we must have a coupon. What else can we do to influence you to go get one?
You know, it's just hard for me to get past the quarter pounder with cheese. You know what I mean? That's kind of my go-to.
Yeah. Well, they'll still be there tomorrow.
That's true.
You can have the Big Mac. What if you fall in love with the Big Mac? And then all of a sudden, now you've got options.
Is it the special sauce?
It is the Thousand Island dressing, yeah.
Well, just tell them to go easy on it. Say light on the sauce.
Or you just get a quarter pounder with cheese.
But this is about you trying something different.
They're totally different
not
burgers.
Not just enjoying what you already know you love. This is about trying something different.
Yeah.
And maybe the sauce combined with
the lettuce.
The lettuce and the burgers. And the onions and the cheese and all of that will just put it over the moon for you, Shaw.
That's all I've been missing in my life.
Didn't they do a Big Mac Jr.?
Yes.
They
which was
do
why,
it?
Which was why I've been an advocate for Shaw because I'm with you. I don't want all of that. I can't like a single patty.
Too much. Don't need the bread in the middle.
Are you even Americans? I can't eat a full Big Mac. Get out of here. Go back to Russia. Poor people. Too hungry to eat a Big Mac.
Just one burger patty, Shaw. Right? Are you with me?
That would be better.
All right. Well, I want a report tomorrow on my desk about the Big Mac. Three-way with Shaw. More of these coming up. We'll get to Bad News Happy Music as well. But now it's Van Halen.
Rock Mornings. Only on 95.7 The Rock.
Rock Mornings with Brian and Gene. Van Halen, Hot for Teacher. I never had a teacher that I was hot for. Not one. Like, all through elementary school when, of course, I was too young to be into...
Care about that, think about that.
But all my teachers in elementary school were old. Like old grandma ladies. I had Mrs. Basil in first grade. She was kind of older. Mrs. Griffin in second grade. She was wicked old. Mrs. Crane was probably, my third grade teacher was probably the youngest teacher that I ever had in elementary school. And I think my mom and her somehow knew each other. I remember running into her one time isn't that like the weirdest thing? When you like run into your teacher outside of school when you're a kid and you're like, what the hell are you doing out? How do you? Shouldn't you be at the school? Yeah, it's like, you're a real human being? What are you doing out here? Yeah, my mom and her apparently knew each other. I just vividly remember running into her at the grocery store one time and thinking, why is my mom talking to my teacher? Like, they know each other.
I didn't have enough male teachers. I had, like, none in grade school. An art teacher, actually. But then in high school, a couple. A history teacher, English teacher.
Yeah, and none of my... I can't remember any teachers in junior high or high school that I found attractive.
I remember that a lot of the young gentlemen in our school had a crush on our German teacher because she was beautiful and could speak a foreign language.
Right. Not a sexy language.
Frau.
Not a German's not a sexy
language. No,
like,
I know.
Like
but...
Spanish or French or something. But my French teacher, I think I've told you this. She used to... we made fun of her all the time because, you know... Chalkboards back then. Mm-hmm. I don't know what the hell they do now. Do they even have chalkboards in there?
But she would...
Well, everything's on the chalkboard, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And so she'd have to erase everything on the chalkboard. Well, she had this glitch in the Matrix where instead of just taking the eraser and erasing the board, her other hand would do the same thing. So, like, she'd be going like this, and her hand was empty. There was nothing going on. It wasn't like she had two erasers. She just, with her right hand, she's got the eraser up there on the chalkboard, and the left hand's just kind of going like this at this. And we just would die laughing in the class. Madame Michaud, 7th, 8th grade French. I did run into, this was a weird thing, because, you know, I went back to school when I was 20. So I dropped out when I was 17 as a senior, because my mom was traveling for business a lot, and my dad was cheating on my mom, and so he was never around, so I just didn't get up and go to school. I skipped school for, like, a month straight, and so I flunked out of school, and then I moved out of my parent, you know, I got kicked out, whatever, and all that stuff. So, anyways, yada, yada, yada.
A couple years go by.
I was in the workforce for a few years, moving around, doing this, doing that, and then finally I was like, you know what, I want to get my diploma. Writing down GED made me feel stupid. That's not to say that it's bad. I'm just saying for me personally, I didn't like it. So I went back, and I had to, like, go and have these interviews with all the, we had a bunch of principals, associate principals and stuff like that, and I had to have big interviews with them because I'm a 20-year-old guy, and I'm going back to high school, like, daily, you know what I mean? Like, going to school on a, not just some night class thing, and you know, there's 15-year-old kids there and whatever. And I knew a bunch of these kids because my friends in high school were like, you know, well, so like I turned 21 before graduation. And so we went out, me and Donut, and we were at some of the local bars. And it was so funny because I ran into some of the teachers.
The,
like,
French teacher was there?
No, not Madame Michaud. She wasn't erasing any chalkboards. But I ran into, like, I don't know, it was a guy who ran detention hall or something like that. And I ran into him, and he's like, what the hell are you? I'm like, dude, I'm 21. I'm like, he's like, oh, I didn't even know. I was like, yeah, I'm the weird kid that came back to high school at the age of 20.
It's almost graduation time. I'm out of here.
I made so much goddamn money that weekend of prom buying beer for kids. Oh, it was glorious. So much money.
Now you'd never do that.
Yes, I would.
No.
That's a good way to make money fast. High school kids offer you extra cash to buy beers. Here's a $50 bill. Get us a case of Keystones.
You know what I mean?
Like, 40 bucks in my pocket. Hell yeah. It was glorious. How do you got? I had to pay rent, man. Yeah. But no, I don't remember any teachers I was hot for. Not a single one. We'll get to more Three Ways with Shaw. Got a special guest joining us to talk about a big event that's coming up in August.
Woo-woo!
Monday Morning Throwback is on the way as well. If you need something, get in touch with us. Visit rockmornings.com.
Rock Mornings, Monday to Friday, 6 to 9.
Rock Mornings with Brian and Gene. Sublime, What I Got. I got a cat named Mr. Cricket. Not a very active cat. He's indoors, so he doesn't have to be outside running around chasing birds and squirrels and rabbits and whatever.
Doesn't have to work for a living. That's what you're saying.
No. And we have, you know, toys for him. He occasionally plays with them, but he doesn't, other than the occasional zoomies, you know, where he runs around the house, there's not a lot of activity for Mr. Cricket. You come in, he's lying around, taking naps. Mm-hmm. But he's not a chunky cat. He's not too bad. Try to keep him fit, you know. Obviously, regular vet visits. Make sure he's not too overweight.
Is this a giant cat story?
It is. It's a giant cat story about a giant cat that has maybe the best giant cat name of all time. 30-pounder. You know how big a 30-pound cat is?
Big cat.
Named Thicken Nugget. Instead of Chicken Nugget, it's Thicken Nugget in Indiana. Slimming down by using an exercise regimen, usually for dogs. You know, cats don't like water for the most part.
Yeah.
Dogs, when they are overweight, they tend to use aqua therapy with the treadmill, right? They put them in there. Low impact, right?
This cat's in water?
Yeah. A place called the Canine Aquatic Center is helping Thicken Nugget swim his way thin. 7 weeks since he showed up, he's lost 5 pounds. They're hoping he can drop another 10 and eventually lose half of his body weight. So go from 30 pounds to 15 pounds. The Vanderburg Humane Society in Evansville, Indiana has Thicken Nugget documenting his weight loss journey. He tries to protest at first, but he swims so well and he gets out and just walks around like he owns the place. I think he actually kind of likes it deep down, said Laura Novak with the Canine Aquatic Center.
He tries to protest at first, but he swims so well and he gets out and just walks around like he owns the place. So I think he actually kind of likes it deep down.
Now, the cat's actual name is Ty, but they have nicknamed him Thick and Nugget.
Okay. He's on a water treadmill, huh? That's
I think you got to just change his name. Ty's weight affecting his joints, could cause severe spinal damage, quality of life being affected. But he's on the road to recovery now at the Canine Aquatic Center doing laps in the pool.
Not normal.
30-pound cat named Thick and Nugget.
Not normal.
Hanging out at the aquatic center.
Cat in the wall, eh?
Actually, no. Cat in the pool. Swimming.
Is your cat making too much noise all the time?
Yeah, if he weighs 30 pounds.
He's in the water.
He's going to make a big sound when he jumps off that counter if he can get up there in the first place. I showed you that video last week. That cat trying to jump up on the counter.
Wasn't making it.
Oof.
Wasn't making it.
Failed attempt. Thicken Nuggets. I wish people would celebrate me losing 5 pounds in 7 weeks.
I'd throw you a party with cakes.
Yeah. Nice. Took me 7 weeks, but I lost 5 pounds. More from Shaw coming up in just a bit. Also got a very special guest joining us later on to announce a very big event that's happening this August in our area. More details coming up in just a few. Stick around.
Rock Mornings with Brian, Gene, and Shaw.
Do you happen to know
what day it is?
This day we all get the crap scared out of us by blood-sucking vampires. Tax day.
Today is the day!
State tax, federal tax, social security tax.
Son, I pay taxes.
I pay taxes!
Taxes? I don't pay no taxes.
Paying taxes? It's tax season.
Bring your taxes.
Done with taxes! Done with taxes!
Showtime.
Put a stamp on it, get it in the mail today. It's tax day.
Until midnight.
Or extension.
Yep.
The big deal is Krispy Kreme. They get the most press out of their buy one, get one dozen deal. Buy a dozen donuts at full price at Krispy Kreme. Get a second dozen for just the sales tax, Shaw.
Okay.
Capitalizing on the fact that it's tax day. Mm-hmm. Lots of chains will be doing some sort of tax day giveaway or freebie or deal. Yeah.
Come spend your tax rebate with us.
Grubhub has $15 off. For April 15th. Makes sense, right? 15 for 15. Spend at least $25. Use the code TAXBREAK on qualifying orders. Limited to the first 1,000 people who use it. So, it's probably gone already? Or is it... Is that what that means? Only 1,000 people get
it? Sounds like it.
Sounds like it.
Hooters, by the way, has a buy one, get one wing deal. Buy 10 wings, get 10 free, Shaw.
All right.
White Castle, 15% off for April 15th. Use the word WC15OFF. And apparently, if you've got stuff to shred, Office Depot and Office Max have a free coupon on their website or on their app.
Okay.
To shred up to 5 pounds of paper between now and next Saturday, the 27th. So some tax day deals. You can Google those if you want to find more, but yeah. Tax day, Shaw.
Yeah, everybody's favorite. I just read last week that the average American spends about $525,000 over the course of their life in taxes. Income tax, property tax, sales tax, gas tax, all that.
And you have almost no say in where that goes.
Right.
When it comes down to it. Yeah. That's a lot of money, Shaw.
Mm-hmm.
Especially when you got crappy-ass roads like we've got. Tax day, get the stamp on it, get it in the mail, or get the extension. IRS.gov, where's my refund, all that stuff?
No refund. Hang in. Got to make adjustments on stuff. Dumb.
What the hell? How are you paying in?
One, well, from Fed, but getting back from state, right? Oh. It's that balance thing where some is this and some is that, and ugh, dumb.
Yeesh. No, thank you.
No, thank you.
Three-way now with Shaw in the newsroom. What else going on?
One man is dead after a motorcycle accident yesterday afternoon. It happened in the town of Barrie. The motorcycle crashed when it left the road on County Highway M while navigating a sharp corner. The cycle crashed into a farm field, and the driver, 62-year-old Robert St. John, was ejected from the motorcycle and was declared dead at the scene. One man is dead after a police chase that ended in Cannon Falls, Minnesota last night. The Dodge County Sheriff's Office says one of its deputies was rammed by the suspect during an attempted traffic stop. After the crash, the driver took off and led police on a high-speed chase. It ended when the suspect pulled into the Mayo Clinic parking lot in Cannon Falls and died of a self-inflicted gunshot wound. Officers fired their weapons. A 33-year-old man taken into custody in connection with a severed human leg found in a Milwaukee area park has now been charged in connection with the woman's death and disappearance.
This is like a first date they were on?
I don't know how they met, but the guy's name is Maxwell Anderson, and he's charged with the death and dismemberment of 19-year-old Shardé Robinson. Police say Anderson killed, then dismembered Robinson with the intent of concealing her slaying. He has been charged with first-degree intentional homicide, mutilating a corpse, and arson. Robinson has been missing since April 1st when she failed to show up for work. Her vehicle was later found torched. Human remains, believed to be that of Robinson, have been found in several other Milwaukee locations, including over the weekend.
I was reading that it was like a first date.
Oh, my God. Yeah,
I don't know. I have not heard that.
I mean, not
scary.
That it matters, but that is horrifying.
Right.
Oof. Horrifying.
Live from New York, it's Caitlin Clark. The Iowa star made a surprise appearance on Saturday Night Live during the show's Weekend Update segment. She said she first heard about the possibility at the Final Four, although discussions had been ongoing for a couple of weeks. She said she was way more nervous to be on television than she is for a basketball game. The Iowa star is in New York for the WNBA draft, which will take place tonight when she's expected to be the top pick by the Indiana Fever. And the Milwaukee Bucks have made the NBA playoffs and now know who they will play. Yeah, the third-seeded Bucks will face the sixth-seeded Indiana Pacers in the first round. That first game will be next Sunday. The Bucks were the top seed last year but lost to the Miami Heat in 2022. They also were the top seed but lost to the Boston Celtics in the conference finals.
Do we know what time that game is?
I have not seen a time. No, just Sunday.
I know they got play-in games.
There's a couple play-in games that will determine some of that.
Okay. All right. Yeah, they've lost 8 of their last
11.
Yeah,
they're not exactly on fire going into the playoffs.
Giannis is injured. Obviously, this extra time off will help, but they had grip on the second seed, and now they've got, you know, demoted to the third seed. It's just, what about?
He's back, though, for the playoffs, supposedly?
That was the plan. They were going to
set him out the last few games of the regular season in hopes that he'll be ready for the playoffs.
Well, and with a week off here now, essentially, between yesterday's game and
Sunday's play-in game.
Yeah. Scott Robert Shaw in the newsroom for another three-way. Next time we talk to you, the Monday morning throwback. Take a look back to 2013. More tax-related stuff.
Okay.
From 11 years ago. I totally forgot we did it, too. Get to that here in about 20 minutes. Got sports coming up. Also some Metallica. If you need something, reach out. Get in touch with us, rockmornings.com.
Rock Mornings on 95.7 The Rock.
Metallica with King Nothing on Rock Mornings with Brian and Gene. Bucks losing both games this weekend to wrap up the regular season. Oklahoma City Thunder on Friday, 125-107. Lost yesterday to the Magic, 113-88. Bucks losing 8 of their last 11 games heading into the playoffs. They fell out of second place in the East thanks to the loss to the Magic coupled with the Knicks' win over the Bulls yesterday. So the Bucks will move on to the playoffs where they'll take on number 6 Indiana. Game 1 of that series is on Sunday. There's obviously some play-in games later this week to determine who's going to be playing in the East and in the West, and then they'll set the times.
Mm-hmm. Sunday sometime, whether it's afternoon or late in the day, evening, we'll see.
Brew Crew took 2 out of 3 from the Orioles this weekend. 11-1 on Friday, 11-5 on Saturday. They lost 6-4 yesterday in the series finale. They're at home for the first of 3 against San Diego tonight at 6:40. Scotty Scheffler got the win at the Masters over the weekend. Chase Elliott got the win at Texas Motor Speedway yesterday, ending a 42-race drought. Chase Elliott.
That's exciting for him.
And Arizona Coyotes players informed on Friday that the team is, in fact, relocating to Utah. And I don't think this is temporary. It sounds like it's permanent.
Is this the hockey team?
Yeah, the Coyotes GM, Bill Armstrong, met with the players ahead of their game against the Oilers to confirm that the NHL is working to facilitate a sale of the team to Ryan and Ashley Smith, who own the Utah Jazz. The Coyotes will begin playing there next season. So Arizona, no hockey for you. Also, I don't know if you saw, you maybe you did, you've got a runner in your house, right?
I do.
Following closely with the Paris Olympics, or no?
I wouldn't say closely.
Did you read about the Nike uniforms?
No.
Didn't go well for the women.
What happened?
Nike revealed on Thursday the first look at the outfits that the U.S. track and field athletes will wear in Paris. And the men's design looks pretty standard. The women's one-piece speed suit features a surprisingly high-cut bikini line that people on Instagram immediately began ripping into. One person said, quote, "There's no way a female runner had any say in that design." Another person said, "I hope USATF is paying for the bikini waxes." Another commenter said, quote, "If the labia are hanging out on a still mannequin, what do we expect to happen to a moving person?" Even some professional runners and Olympic hopefuls are commenting and weighing in on the design. Long jump star Tara Davis Woodhall, a favorite to make this year's Olympic team, said, quote, "Wait, my hoo-ha is going to be out." Colleen Quigley, a pro steeplechase athlete.
I saw this. There's absolutely no, not made for performance.
And former Olympian wrote, quote, "I mean, I still want to make the team, but..." Worried anxiety face.
Yeah.
Pro trail runner Grayson Murphy said, quote, "That gusset is giving me anxiety." Lauren Fleshman, a retired U.S. world champion runner, had some much harsher criticism to share. In an Instagram post, Fleshman wrote, quote, "I'm sorry, but show me one WNBA or NWSL team who would enthusiastically support this kit. This is for Olympic track and field. Professional athletes should be able to compete without dedicating brain space to constant pube vigilance or the mental gymnastics of having every vulnerable piece of your body on display. Women's kits should be in service to performance, mentally and physically. If this outfit was truly beneficial to physical performance, men would wear it."
Looks like a swimsuit bottom.
Oh, yeah. And again, if you're running and stretching and moving and the legs are going here and there and you're jumping and everything's spread.
Hurdles?
Yeah.
That's part of track and field.
All that stuff. Going over the pole vault or
did
something.
They not ask?
I have no idea. Nike responded. Apparently, they said something like you could try wearing shorts. It didn't go well for Nike this week with this whole USA track and field women's outfit.
Yeah, I see. Pole vaulting.
That's what I just said. I mean, you're going up there, the legs are all everywhere and which way?
Yeah.
Huh.
I'm sure they'll work on making some changes. They got a
range of options, Nike says. They're going to have a range of options to choose from.
A few more months to figure it out.
It's not going to be all of this. It could be tailoring options for other bottoms, I guess.
Yeah, if that many female athletes are coming out and be like, did you talk to anybody about it? Did you meet with any females that actually perform these activities? Maybe not. Monday Morning Throwback is coming up in just a bit. You can reach out to us by visiting rockmornings.com. We'll get to some Motionless in White next.
Rock Mornings with Brian, Gene, and Shaw.
Maybe this will refresh your memory.
Since 2008, Brian, Gene, and Shaw have been your wake-up specialists.
Like old times, huh?
Now it's time to take a look back.
Go way back.
It's the Monday Morning Throwback. Every Monday morning, Throwback.
Taking you all the way back to 2013, I completely forgot about this one, Shaw.
You said it was tax-related.
Yeah. Tax day on April 15th in 2013 was also on a Monday. And we must have given Scrady some homework over the weekend. Mm.
To come up with his taxes? To come up with a tax song.
One of the things that we really enjoyed doing while Scrady was on the program for all those years was having him write and perform original songs here on the program. Obviously, the Thursday song, that's where that came from. He had a song that he wrote about going to an adult prom with Danielle Fishel, right? Didn't he write a song about her, the chick from Boy Meets World?
Original song that I wrote and performed.
Didn't he do a Jackyl song as well?
He did.
Where he played the chainsaw on the back of my truck.
Mm-hmm. That's true.
Like he borrowed Phil's chainsaw and was out there playing it.
It was actually my chainsaw, as I recall.
Was it?
Yeah.
Okay. I think Phil had to start it for him. That was the problem. So, yeah, we had Scrady perform a number of songs on the program. He wrote them, and he performed them.
Yes,
and
this was original numbers.
And this was another one, Shaw. This was Scrady's tax song from 2013. I think the title of the song was "Before You Take My Taxes, Take This." And here is a very short clip of Scrady singing his tax song from 2013.
Okay, here we go. Today is the worst day, the worst day of all. Today is the tax day, the day that I dread. Today is the day I'd rather be dead. Uncle Sam, Uncle Sam, you know that I love you. Uncle Sam, Uncle Sam, you know that I love you. But not today. But not today.
So breathy. So much breathing.
Oof.
For those of you that don't know, maybe you're just tuning in from Eau Claire and you have no idea who this Scrady character is. We had a guy on the show that worked here for a number of years that sounded just like that. His name was Matt Scrady, and yes, that's his real voice. And
it's his real song that he wrote.
He would occasionally be on the program with us, and we would have him do funny things and quirky things. And one of those things was to write and perform his very own song, Sean, the tax song from 2013.
Yeah, even though he wasn't a singer, but you know.
No, or a musician in any way, shape, or form. But if you want to hear the rest of that, it's on our website, the Monday Morning Throwback. Scrady's tax song from 2013. Before you take my taxes, take this.
I love you, Uncle Sam.
But not today.
Well, that was a guy that was struggling too, I think, at the time. Not everything was.
He was probably one of the people that's procrastinating the 47% of Americans who don't do their taxes in time.
Wait
and
till
ask
the last
for an
minute.
Extension.
Yeah.
Get another 6 months.
The rest of the tax song, again, available on our website, the Monday Morning Throwback, Scrady's tax song. What else is happening?
A Milwaukee man is being charged with first-degree murder in the death of a woman whose severed leg was found on a lakefront beach. Maxwell Anderson also is charged with mutilating a corpse and arson. Sharday Robinson was killed in early April. Her leg was discovered by a passerby at a park in Cudahy. Other body parts have been found scattered throughout the Milwaukee area.
Yeah.
Robinson was reported missing one day after being seen on a date with Anderson. Her burned car was found after the date. Now that the April election is done in western Wisconsin, winners of the spring races are getting down to government business. The La Crosse School Board will meet tonight for its last regular session before reorganization next week. This week's meeting will be the last one for three board members who chose not to seek new terms. On Tuesday, the La Crosse County Board will have its first post-election meeting. All 30 board seats are up for election this month. Seven new supervisors are joining the board for two-year terms. Senator Tammy Baldwin has a few million dollars in her campaign bank account as she runs for re-election. The Baldwin campaign says it has raised just over $5 million during the first 3 months of this year from 18,000 donors around Wisconsin. Campaign officials say teachers and healthcare workers are among the most frequent donors to Democrat Baldwin. 12 news organizations have urged presumptive presidential nominees Joe Biden and Donald Trump to agree to debates, saying they were a rich tradition that had been part of every general election campaign since 1976. While Trump, who did not participate in debates for the Republican nomination, has indicated a willingness to take on his 2020 rival, the president has not committed to debating him again. The news organization said it was not too early for each campaign to say publicly that it will participate in the three presidential debates and one vice presidential forum set by the Nonpartisan Commission on Presidential Debates.
Speaking of, has Trump picked a
running mate? No.
A VP running mate?
No, he's not.
Is that
A lot of times that happens after they formally accept the nomination at the Republican or Democratic convention. Yeah. A burning ban has been issued for the city of La Crosse and the town of Mandaree. And no sooner was that ban announced over the weekend than La Crosse firefighters were called out to a grass fire in Mandaree yesterday. Fire crews say high winds apparently spread those flames from a fire pit where a homeowner was burning garbage. About 2 acres of land were burned in the area of Deerfield Road, but no structures were damaged. The fire danger in the La Crosse area is likely to be at a very high level for the next couple of days.
So the storm system that's moving in, speaking of high winds affecting Eau Claire and Chippewa Valley and us, and we're talking about most of western Wisconsin, strong winds developing 20 to 35 miles an hour, 45. They're saying a tornado isn't even out of the question, maybe. That's how severe these storms could be moving in tomorrow into Wednesday, and maybe 1 to 2 inches
heavy
rain possible, which, you know, everything's so dry, so it'll run right off. So it'll be interesting.
Three-way with Shaw in the newsroom. We'll get back to him in just a bit. We've got a very special guest joining us after Jackyl. It would be the lead singer of Jackyl. Jesse James Dupree going to join us on the phone here in just a couple of minutes. Big announcement coming up.
Rock Mornings on your rock station.
Brian and Gene on the phone with our good friend Jesse James Dupree of Jackyl. Woo! It's been a minute since we've talked to you, sir. And usually when we talk to you, you talk at us. We just sort of start the engine and let it go. We've got a big thing coming up in August, and you're on the phone to tell us more about it.
Well, you know, it's good to be talking to you guys again. And, you know, I wake up every day and take as big a bite out of life fast as I possibly can. So it just adds to the fuel that adds to the fire that I'm excited to announce that Jackyl is finally making our way back to La Crosse. It's been a minute since we've had a Jackyl family reunion and with La Crosse, and so we're excited about coming back, and it's tied into this big rally that you've got going on. And I mean, I think we go together like pretzels and beer.
Yeah, Jesse, how many of the motorcycle rallies across the country have you been to? Obviously, you're in Sturgis every year, but do you go to Laconia and down to Daytona and all that stuff too, or is there any that you've missed?
You know, we are annually at all those events. Just I do work with Harley Davidson Motor Company, and we do a lot of fun things where I've been part of giving. God, I think I gave away my 18th Harley Davidson motorcycle in Daytona just a couple of months ago. So yeah, we're in all those events, and I mean Daytona is like 80 something years old now. Laconia is the oldest motorcycle rally in the world. It's 101 years old this year, and then of course, you know, Harley Davidson's anniversary is coming up in Milwaukee, and then we got Sturgis, like you said. But right now, I'm just focused on La Crosse. I'm focused on coming back in and getting the word out, because we're gonna bring it, and I promise you, we're gonna make up for all this lost time, because it's been a minute since we've played there. And it's, I mean, Wisconsin, just some of the you know, the most genuine, you know, dedicated rock people out there. I mean, people that bust their knuckles 40, 50 hours a week or more. And when people in Wisconsin get ready to jam, they want to do it loud, proud, hard, and honest. And that's what Jackyl's going to be bringing to the party when we show up there to partner with you guys and throw the damnedest party of 2024.
Yeah, it's called the Big River Rally, and it happens August 16th and 17th right here in La Crosse, mostly down at the Fest Grounds. And similar to Daytona, Laconia, Sturgis, we're going to have motorcycles. We're going to have rides. We're going to have guided rides throughout the Cooley region. We got tons and hundreds of miles of beautiful scenery. We've got vendors. We're going to have music. We're going to have beers. We're going to have food trucks. And, of course, speaking of music, not just Jackyl, we've also got Buck Cherry coming to town with you guys. It's going to be a hell of a weekend.
Oh, what a great band. I mean, they played with us in Michigan a couple of months ago, and I'm a huge fan of that band. You guys got a great lineup, and it's going to be fun. You know, it's about not just the rally that you've got going. It's a celebration. It's a celebration of the fundamentals of rock and roll. That's what it is. It's a celebration, 2 guitar, bass, and drums, chainsaw, if you will, whatever it takes to get the job done, and we're going to bring it. I generally find that people that know what I'm talking about when I say we're celebrating the fundamentals of rock and roll, those people, they realize that it's not about coming to see the show. It's about coming to be part of the show, right? It's about coming out there and celebrating these fundamentals. I also find that the people that don't understand when I talk about celebrating the fundamentals of rock and roll, those are generally the same people that have a hard time admitting that they masturbate.
Well, Jesse, I am a full-fledged card-holding member of that club, I'll tell you. Right hand and left hand occasionally, Jesse. You know me. That's how I get down.
Yeah.
BigRiverRally.com is where you're going to find the information, Jesse. As Brian mentioned, August 16th is Buck Cherry. August 17th is Jackyl. Now, you have been in our area, well, in Wisconsin, a number of times. But, you know, as a rider, a person who really enjoys that lifestyle and that freedom out on the roads, you've been here in the Cooley region. What do you think about some of the roads and routes and highways and byways of this area?
Well, you know, we actually participated in one of your rides, a big charity ride that you guys did a couple of years back. And I was, first of all, it's absolutely beautiful up there. We rode up, it was the waterway, the river. Was it a river that we ran up?
Oh, yeah, probably Mississippi.
Yeah, and we stopped along the way. There's a bunch of different bars and stuff that we stopped at and just had a great day. And that was despite the fact that it was raining, like with some of the hardest rain I've ever ridden in. And I would just, I still to this day, brag to people all over the country about that ride that we did in La Crosse, because it did not deter anybody. I mean, nope. We all left out. We were all soaking wet, and we you know what we did? We made some memories, and I brag about it all the time. Then that everybody stood up, and eventually the rain cleared out, and we had a beautiful rest of the day. And but some it is some incredible riding up there, but more so, just great people. And I do brag about that ride all the time, but it was a wet one.
Yeah, Jesse James Dupree of Jackyl on the phone with us. This is going to be really cool because we're going to have guided rides throughout the area. We're going to have stunt bikes as well, stunt show. Now, those things are really fun. I know they have those out at the Speedway occasionally, and those guys can do some incredible things with their motorcycles. We're going to have food. We're going to have beers. We're going to have live music. It's the Big River Rally. It goes down again August 16th and 17th, and Jesse is going to be here with Roman and the guys. It's just going to be a hell of a good time.
Yeah, absolutely, and I appreciate being invited to the party. People spread the word, put it on your calendar, make your plans, get the chrome polished up and get ready to go. And whether you ride or not, it's going to be all kind of excuses for you to get out there and celebrate those fundamentals with us. So thank you guys for letting me get on here and announce it to everybody. Buck Cherry, great band. Jackyl, I promise you we're going to bring it. And we're gonna make it count. We're going to leave the damnedest stain we can muster up, I promise you.
Details, BigRiverRally.com. Tickets on sale this Friday at 6 a.m. $30, Jesse, making it affordable for the hardworking men and women throughout the region, the state of Wisconsin, the tri-state area, the Cooley region, to come down and participate with vendors and stunt shows and rides and food and beverages and real rock and roll brought up loud in your face Friday night, August 16th, Buck Cherry. Saturday night, August 17th, Jackyl at the Oktoberfest grounds. Again, BigRiverRally.com with tickets on sale this Friday.
I appreciate you, Goose. Get ready to rock, people.
The one and only Jesse James Dupree of Jackyl joining us on the program this morning to talk about Big River Rally. You can find out more by going to BigRiverRally.com. It's a motorcycle event similar to Laconia, Sturgis, Daytona, any of those motorcycle rallies where you get a bunch of people from outside the area to come into town, ride on the beautiful roads that we have here in the Cooley region. Check out all sorts of really cool vendors that we've got in the area. Obviously, we know S&S Cycle, and there's a ton of other really cool places around here that deal with motorcycles. Bunch of, you know, bike shops in the area. Going to have music from Jackyl and Buck Cherry, plus some local openers. Food and music and beers and just everything. It's going to be awesome.
Mm-hmm.
Big River Rally. Check out more info online at BigRiverRally.com. Tickets go on sale, by the way, this Friday at 6 a.m. at BigRiverRally.com. Thanks again to Jesse James Dupree for joining us on the phone. We'll get back to Shaw in just a bit. Also, some 3 Days Grace coming up.
More of your Rock Mornings coming up in just a bit.
Rock Mornings with Brian and Gene. That is 3 Days Grace, Everything About You. Maisie Williams is 27. You know her better as Arya Stark from Game of Thrones. Apparently, the Jon Snow Game of Thrones spinoff is not going to happen.
Mm-hmm.
We got the House of the Dragons and all that, but yeah, apparently the Jon Snow spinoff, not going to happen.
Not going to be a thing.
Maisie Williams, 27 years old today. Happy birthday to her. Emma Watson, 34. You know her best as Hermione Granger from the Harry Potter movies and a bunch of other stuff, but obviously most people know her as Hermione Granger. Why is when something goes wrong, it's always you three? Ever watch all those?
Yes.
Kids?
Yeah.
They read the books?
One of them.
Nerd?
Yep.
Seth Rogen, 42. That's all you need to know about Seth Rogen. It's that laugh. Speaking of a guy who was on SNL this weekend, Chris Stapleton, 46.
It's his birthday today. Happy birthday.
Yeah. On SNL this weekend.
Mm-hmm.
I'm trying to watch that. Maybe tonight. Phil Labonte of All That Remains, lead singer, 49 years young today. Samantha Fox, British singer.
Yeah.
From the 80s. Naughty Girls Need Love, too.
My body all night long.
58 years old today, Samantha Fox. I think she was like one of those Page Three girls, right?
Mm.
Showing her boobs in the newspaper and became a pop star. Linda Perry, 59. I said, hey. What's going on, Gene? Linda Perry, 59. Born on Blondes.
Mm-hmm.
Now she's a writer and producer. Written a ton of hits. Ton of them. On this day in 1865, 159 years ago, Abraham Lincoln died at 7:22 a.m. Andrew Johnson was sworn in as the 17th president. Lincoln, the first president to be assassinated. Shot the night before, of course, at the Ford Theater by John Wilkes Booth and three other presidents assassinated. Since then, James Garfield, William McKinley, and John F. Kennedy. 1947, Jackie Robinson became the first African American to play in a regular season Major League Baseball game.
That's why it's Jackie Robinson Day today.
Yep, Jackie Robinson Day today. 1955, as we mentioned earlier, 69 years ago, Ray Kroc opening the first McDonald's restaurant in DePlain, Illinois. Originally sold milkshake machines, and when he saw how much business they made for the McDonald's Brothers restaurant in Southern California, he sold him the idea of letting him open his own McDonald's across the country, and that's what he did. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba. I'm loving it. And with any luck, later on today, Shaw will enjoy his very first ever Big Mac. In contrast to the guy who eats nothing but Big Macs, which is also in Wisconsin.
That's true. He does it every day multiple times. Shaw has never.
Crazy. Not once in his entire life
has he ever had.
And he's almost 60.
Never had a Big Mac.
Not once. Never had a hankering for it. 41 years ago today, 1983, Flashdance in theaters. Starring Jennifer Beals. Irene Cara got an Oscar for her song, original song. Flashdance, What a Feeling. Body double, right? Jennifer Beals?
Supposedly.
I think during the lovemaking scenes, they use a body double. 36 years ago today, 1988, Colors in theaters. Starring Sean Penn as a rookie cop who gets partnered with the old guy, Robert Duvall, in East L.A. Ice-T on the theme song. I'm a nightmare walking, psychopath talking, king of my jungle. And on the anniversary of Jackie Robinson becoming the first African-American to play in a baseball game, 1997, 27 years ago, the number 42 permanently retired throughout all of Major League Baseball. Joey Ramone, on this day in 2001, passed away at the age of 49. Lymphatic cancer got him 23 years ago today. Mm-hmm. And 11 years ago today, 2013, more than 260 people wounded, three people killed when the two bombs went off near the finish line of the Boston Marathon. Oof. Personally, one of the scariest days in my life, as I've told this story before, in New England, Patriots Day, which is usually right around Marathon Monday, is a day that most people in New England take the day off. They go down to Boston. They catch the marathon. There's a Red Sox game. There's a lot to do. And
I have friends and family that go
there every year. And when this all happened, much like 9/11, the cell service became very difficult to use. Everyone was frantically trying to get in touch with loved ones. I had friends that were half a block away from the explosions. And thankfully, they're all okay and everything. But it was just a
scary time. Very scary time. And then the shooters on the run for, what, a week or more? Where they
It was crazy because they shut down the city of Boston. And it was something I had never even you're talking about a major metropolitan area, mm-hmm. and they completely shut it. Like, there was no traffic. Nobody was going anywhere as they searched for the brothers there, and then eventually caught up with them, and they killed a
security guard at the university, wasn't it?
Yeah, I don't know if he was. I think he was more like a it's like the UWL. He's a cop as opposed to a security guard. But yeah, and then, of course, the boat and all that stuff. So, but there you go. So birthdays and pop culture dates. We'll get to, back to Shaw here in just a couple minutes. Also get to some sleep theory.
Rock Mornings. On air. Online. On the app.
Rock Mornings with Brian and Gene Shaw in the newsroom, and you might have heard us talking to Jesse James Dupree a little while ago, Shaw. Our good friend Jesse James Dupree from Jackyl, who's been in the area many, 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 many times over the years. In fact, I was going back through some photos, and I saw a picture of him and Big Daddy Know-It-All, the boss man, with that goofy hat with the feather in the top. Remember that?
Yep.
Yeah, that was from, like, I don't know, a dozen years ago, but we've had some good times with Jackyl, and they've always delivered when it comes to putting on a show. This time around, it's not just a Jackyl show, though. It's Jackyl on one night, Buck Cherry on the other night, and it's a weekend full of motorcycles, rides, vendors, food, music, and a whole lot more. It's called the Big River Rally, and it happens on August 16th and 17th down at the Southside Fest Grounds. But much like any kind of motorcycle gathering, Shaw, some mm-hmm. sort of motorcycle weekend like Daytona, Sturgis.
Sure.
Going to be riders from all around the region, all around the area, whether it's Iowa, Minnesota, mm-hmm. whether it might be Illinois or even other side of the state. People coming from all around to celebrate the beautiful riding area that we have here in the Cooley region. True. We've got some of the best road, I mean, not in terms of quality.
Scenery,
but
anyway.
Scenery, yeah. Some of the, and they're kind of, you know, obviously we know about the cut through Mindoro, and we know about some of the other rides through the area, but man, there's the River Road, obviously, that mm-hmm. goes down towards Minnesota. We got a problem with the bridge down there right now, but there's plenty of other beautiful rides through the area, and we're going to be having guided rides. I think Jesse might actually take one of the guided rides, the one on Saturday morning. There's also going to be a lot of vendors, obviously, stuff for your motorcycle. You want to pimp it out. You want to get maybe some custom leather stuff done. You want to talk about doing, you know, some customizing to your bike. You can certainly do that. Obviously, there's going to be food down there, food trucks, which I'm so excited about. Mm-hmm. You know me, Shaw. I'm a fat guy. I like to eat.
There'll be more information coming, too. Veterans Breakfast on Saturday morning to benefit some local veterans organizations. So Big River Rally. Just mark your calendar at this point and think about accommodations. And
that's a Friday, Saturday. So Friday night, it'll be Buck Cherry along with some opening bands. And then on Saturday, it'll be Jackyl Stock. Pa-pow!
And you can get tickets starting on Friday morning.
Tickets on sale this Friday. For the Big River Rally. Find it online at BigRiverRally.com. But yeah, very cool to have Jesse James Dupree join us a little while ago and talk about that, and looking forward to riding through the area with him. Be good times.
Absolutely.
And try to keep up.
It's hard. It's difficult to do.
Yeah.
Something.
What else is going on?
The woman convicted of killing the director of Wisconsin Public Media in a collision in Madison is heading to prison. Shanicia Yumas has been sentenced to 2.5 years behind bars. She hit a motorcycle driven by Jean Purcell near the Wisconsin Public Broadcasting Building in 2021. Yumas was traveling at 65 miles per hour, less than 2 seconds before the crash. The speed limit on that stretch of road is 30 miles per hour. The wife of a former Harvard Medical School morgue manager has pleaded guilty to a federal charge after investigators said she shipped stolen human body parts, including hands, feet, and heads, to buyers across the country. 64-year-old...
Is this the skin lamp lady, right?
Kind of, yes. 64-year-old Denise Lodge of New Hampshire has pleaded guilty in Pennsylvania to a charge of interstate transportation of stolen goods. Federal prosecutors last year announced charges against Lodge, along with her husband Cedric and 5 others, in an alleged scheme in which a nationwide network of people bought and sold human remains that had been stolen from Harvard, as well as a mortuary in Arkansas. Prosecutors allege that Denise Lodge negotiated online sales of a number of items between 2018 and 2020, including 2 dozen hands, 2 feet, 9 spines, portions of skulls, 5 dissected human faces, and 2 dissected heads.
Gross. Disgusting.
The weapons supervisor on the set of the Alec Baldwin movie Rust will be sentenced today in New Mexico after she was convicted of involuntary manslaughter in the 2021 death of a cinematographer. Hannah Gutierrez-Reed faces up to 18 months in prison in the death of Helena Hutchins, who was shot when Baldwin pointed a gun at her during a rehearsal and it went off. Baldwin's involuntary manslaughter trial is scheduled to begin in July. It may soon cost more to mail a card or letter. The U.S. Postal Service is asking for permission to raise the price of stamps for the second time in 6 months. If the change gets the green light, a first-class stamp will jump from 68 cents to 73 cents starting in July. Conjoined twins, Lori and George Chappell, who pursued separate careers, interests, and relationships during lives that defied medical expectations, have died in Pennsylvania. They were 62. The twins, listed by Guinness World Records as the oldest living conjoined twins, died at the hospital at the University of Pennsylvania. The cause of death was not detailed. The twins, born in 1961, had distinct brains but were joined at the skull. George, who had spina bifida and was 4 inches shorter, was wheeled around by Lori on an adaptive wheeled stool. Despite each having to go where the other went, they say it was very important to both to live as independently as possible, according to the obituary. Both graduated from high school and took college classes. George went along for 6 years as Lori worked in a hospital laundry. Lori, a trophy-winning bowler, according to the obituary, gave up her job in the mid-90s so her sibling could launch a country music career. Lori was once engaged to be married, but her fiancé died in an automobile accident.
Hmm.
Wow.
Yeah, they beat the odds. They were only supposed to live to about 30.
Three-way with Shaw in the newsroom. We got bad news, happy music coming up. Also, the friggin' sports. We'll do that right after Sleep Theory. It's numb.
Rock Mornings with Brian, Gene, and Shaw.
Rock Mornings with Brian and Gene. That is Sleep Theory and numb. The friggin' sports. Brought to you by food. Now, you were out on vacation just as the Major League Baseball season was beginning.
Yes.
And while you were gone,
did you guys talk about all
we talked about some of the new ballpark offerings. I wanted to bring back a couple just to make you aware. Brew Crew just got done with a 3-game series in Baltimore against the Orioles, where they took 2 out of 3 from Baltimore. Don't know if any of the players had the warehouse dog while they were in Baltimore, but
okay, I'm interested. Speak to me.
It's a fully loaded foot-long hot dog at home games for the Orioles called the Warehouse Dog. 12 inches long, horseradish-infused brick sauce. My guess is their brick sauce is like their
like the Chick-fil-A
sauce. You know, they got some kind of sauce. Pit beef queso fundido, pickled pico and onions on a pretzel bun. The Warehouse Dog, new at Camden Yards or wherever the hell the Orioles play now. Pirates, meanwhile, Pittsburgh Pirates, have a new food item called the Renegade. It's another foot-long hot dog. This one, though, is topped with potato pierogies, pot roast, pickles, and onions.
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah. The Renegade at Pittsburgh
sounds
Pirates
like
games.
A meal is what it sounds like. Big meal.
Yeah.
Pot
like
roast and potatoes and
potato pierogies.
Yeah, so they're dumpling potatoes on top of the hot dog
with pickles and onions.
Roast beef.
And last but not least, in food-related sports news, you probably didn't see this one, but Boban, you know the guy, the big, huge guy with the big ears and the goldfish commercials, Boban.
Yes.
With the big hand, little fish. That guy.
What?
Well, he's a basketball player. Did you know that? Like, that's his day job. And he plays for the Houston Rockets, and they are, well, they were essentially eliminated from the playoffs yesterday. But during the game, he was able to pay it forward for fans of the LA Clippers. They have a promotion that they run called Brickin' for Chicken, where if an opposing player misses 2 free throws in a row, everyone gets free chicken from Chick-fil-A. And Boban missed his first free throw, and even though they don't have a horse in the race, Boban said, "I got you, I got you." And the video's great. The crowd starts to get amped up because he missed the first one.
And they know that they're like,
"Man, if he misses the second one, we're getting some chicken. And Boban hears it, and he knows it, and he's like, "I got you, I got you." And he's pointing to himself, and then he goes and he intentionally misses the second free throw, doesn't give a rat's ass about the outcome. No, he didn't airball it. I'll give him credit. He at least tried to hit the rim, and he did, but yeah, the fans went wild.
Fans are getting excited here. There might potentially be some free chicken on the board if he misses the second free throw.
Oh, man, free chicken on the board.
Yeah, so that's why the fans are getting a little frothy.
Oh, they're pointing to you. Boban's playing with the crowd. Say, you want chicken?
Here's your job.
No, he gave him chicken. He's a man of the people. He's of the people.
He did that on purpose?
He did. He gave out free chicken.
He's a man of the people.
Houston eliminated from the playoffs. Clippers locked into the four seed. Game didn't really matter in terms of anything, but...
Oh, he's got him. He's got him.
Pointed to himself. He's like, I got
he's
you.
A man of the
I got you. Boban. I got you.
Oh, they're going to get free chicken.
Man of the people.
They're getting the free chicken.
So funny. Big hand, little fish. Friggin' sports brought to you by food. Free chicken, man of the people. Bad news, happy music, and Pearl Jam coming up in just a bit.
Rock mornings, only on 95.7 The Rock.
You're about to enter a beautiful, exciting, wonderful new world.
A cockroach living in your nostril.
Now that's just nasty.
Add in some... Haven't pooped for 30 days.
Poop is raining from the ceilings. Poop.
And sprinkle in some hashtag Florida Man for flavor.
Florida Man.
Florida Man.
Florida Man.
Florida Man.
Florida Man.
Florida Man.
Florida Man quits his Burger King job, steals all of their chicken nuggets.
It's bad news.
Bad news.
With happy music.
Let's rock.
All right, let's start the week off strong, Shaw. What do we got?
Well, a man stabbed his mother to death and injured his father after an argument went awry at their home in Taiwan. The argument apparently had to do with a remote control. Apparently, the man picked up a knife and attacked the mother, stabbing her repeatedly in the chest and abdomen. The father heard the commotion and went to check on them, discovering his wife lying in a pool of blood. He tried to stop his son, causing both to get injured in the struggle that ensued. Police later arrested the son, who suffered injuries to his hands.
Wow.
Last month, a stowaway was caught flying Delta Airlines from Salt Lake City to Austin, Texas. They found him after he snapped a photo of a child's boarding pass and used that to get on the plane and then hid in the bathroom. It turns out it was a full flight, so there were no empty seats, and the plane ended up turning around and going back to the gate.
How do you hide in the bathroom?
I don't know.
Isn't the bathroom just barely big enough for you to fit in there? So were people coming in and going to the bathroom while he was in there hiding?
No, I don't think so. No.
Okay, so he just locked himself in the bathroom.
Perhaps,
okay,
yeah.
Okay, gotcha.
The child's boarding pass that he showed to the ticket agent had already been used, but the gate agent overrode it and let them board anyway. A passenger sitting in front of the coach cabin saw a family of five seat themselves. Two of those seats were already occupied. A flight attendant came over to sort out the duplicate seats. She asked the two men for their boarding passes. One of them kept showing her a screenshot on his phone and also said his sister booked the ticket for him. Well, the men were asked to disembark to get things sorted at the gate, and it seemed like matters were solved, and the flight took off. However, when they arrived, turns out there were more stowaways on the plane. 4 to 5 police officers and an FBI agent boarded while passengers remained seated, and three guys apparently somehow seated in the back of the plane were taken off by security.
Oh my gosh.
So there was like six people that got on this plane that didn't have tickets?
Well, at least three that made it. Two people got escorted off before the plane left, but there were still three people on board who did not have tickets.
Is this like a regular occurrence? Or
I don't know. I hope not.
I'm never flying again.
A woman is suing Tesla after her toddler ran her over back in 2018 while she was 8.5 months pregnant with her second child. Mallory Harcourt's son, who was just 2 at the time, was somehow able to start the car and hit her at her home in Santa Barbara, California, after escaping as she was trying to change his diaper. Her son reached up and touched the gear shift lever, which took the car out of park and into drive. Then he contacted the accelerator pedal, which caused the car to begin moving forward.
So she's got the toddler in the car?
No, she was trying to change his diaper. He ran off, got into the car,
and was able to move.
She went after him. The collision was severe enough to break several of her bones. Fortunately, she was quickly whisked off to a hospital and ended up giving birth to her daughter just a week later. She's now accusing Tesla of manufacturing a defective vehicle, despite advertising the Model X as the safest SUV on the market. Her attorneys claim the EV maker is at fault for the collision due to the Tesla's unsafe design. Meanwhile, Tesla has shot back, arguing that the unfortunate event was a result of Mrs. Harcourt's own negligence in leaving her son unattended.
So easy a toddler can do it?
Right.
I mean, the kid was able to get into the car,
get it out of park,
turn it on,
drive,
put
and
it
accelerate.
And then Jesus.
It's now up to a jury in California to decide whether Tesla's vehicle design is to blame for allowing the toddler to run over his own mother. The 20-year-old driver recently caught going 199 miles an hour on a Florida highway has copped to a reckless driving charge. Luis Lozano Figuera entered a no-contest plea to the misdemeanor count. He was ordered to pay about $900 in fines and fees and will have to undergo an aggressive driving class. Lozano Figuera was arrested in January when cops spotted his Chevy Camaro in a street race along the Florida Turnpike. When police searched the vehicle, they found a camera that had a mounting stick inside the car, which recorded his speed at 199 miles an hour.
Whoa.
He was apparently making
speed
videos for Instagram, apparently.
Great. Wonderful. That's what you want.
An officer in Canada responded to reports of a crash on a highway. When the officer got there, he found the smashed vehicle and the man who was behind the wheel. His vehicle had suffered serious front end damage after colliding with a concrete barricade and needed to be towed from the scene. The man allegedly confessed to police that he was reaching for a piece of fried chicken just before he smashed into the barrier. They say distracted driving is one of the leading causes of fatal accidents on Canadian roads.
Do you have a whole bucket in there?
I think so.
Really? Was it a breast or a thigh?
I don't know.
You don't know?
Delicious hot drumstick? Fried chicken, right?
Didn't have any specifics? I mean,
drumstick would be the way to go if you're behind the wheel, probably, right?
Yeah. It's easy. Yeah, it's got easy. It's got the lollipop kind of aspect where you got the...
I prefer
you
know, the breast.
Popeye's chicken is the shiznit!
Yes. I'd prefer that, though.
What, was
a
he going
big
for
breast
the,
and eat on that.
Is he going for the mac and cheese as well? Like a little scoop of that?
I don't think
just references chicken.
Side dishes.
What are your sides, Shaw? Fried chicken. What are your sides?
Oh, let's see. Baked beans probably would be there.
Mm.
You know, potato salad maybe.
Mm.
How about you?
Mac and cheese.
Mac and cheese. No hesitation.
Maybe mashed potatoes or coleslaw.
Coleslaw, yeah.
Yeah. I'm weird. I'm a weird Irish guy. I like mashed potatoes, but not plain. I like them with like roasted garlic in them. You know what I mean?
Sure. They're delicious that way.
Yeah. As opposed to just plain old mashed potatoes with gravy.
People are obsessed with how tipping culture is out of control, but sometimes it has a bit of a negative vibe, or maybe it's even straight up extortion. An airline passenger says they're at a United ticketing counter at the Newark, New Jersey airport.
You got a tip there.
And the agent said their checked bag was a half pound too heavy. The agent said, "Don't worry, I didn't see anything," and gave the customer a high five. The customer thought they were getting a nice break. But then he said, "You can leave a tip right here," pointing to a spot on the counter. The customer asked if he was for real. The guy said yes, so they left $5. They said they didn't care at first, but later it felt strange, especially since they were pretty sure their bag was not over the limit. They weighed it themselves when they got home. It was 44 pounds, so they figured they have likely been scammed, and they reported the incident to United.
I'm not tipping the guy at the counter.
No, if you check in curbside, which some airports will allow you to do, and then they'll take your bags. You know, you tip that guy because he's dragging your luggage around.
They had it on Seinfeld. How much do you get for a bag? $5 usually. Right? If someone's providing you with a service like that, yeah. Same as a Lyft driver or Domino's delivery dude or whatever. But like, if you're just doing your job behind the counter, and you think you, like, gave me some kind of deal and I'm going to tip you for it? No.
Well, how many people are getting fooled by that?
Right.
They're close to the weight limit.
Many
and they're like, you know
possible.
What I mean?
Because that $5 is a lot cheaper than paying for a second bag.
$100 if you're over 50 pounds.
In Houston, Texas, a 29-year-old mother allegedly left her kids home alone for several days while she went on a cruise to Puerto Rico. Leslie Woods Williams is accused of leaving her apartment on April 4th to catch a flight to Miami. However, she didn't return until days later. Deputies responded to a welfare check at her apartment where they found her 8-year-old son and 6-year-old daughter home alone. Deputies said the apartment smelled of urine and had trash and leftover food thrown everywhere. The children told deputies their mother left for a trip, but while on vacation, the kids said she would use a webcam and a cell phone to check in on them.
Oh, that'd be fine.
The mom is now charged with abandonment of a child.
Come on!
She didn't get the Kenosha kickers to give her a ride home?
Exactly. Should have. Some people don't want to do acupuncture because they're scared of needles. Well, there's something else to be worried about now. A healthcare provider in Iowa who specializes in acupuncture is in trouble because after they inserted the needles, they ran back home for a bit, fell asleep, and completely forgot about the patient.
How long?
The patient waited 2 hours after the session was supposed to end.
Is there no one else in the office?
Apparently
that came
not.
In that, it's just the one person?
Then ended up pulling the needles out themselves and called the police. The worker's name is Dave Wang. He won't face any actual charges, but he could lose his medical license. The State Board of Medicine has fined him $500. The patient wasn't hurt, just confused.
Did he live nearby?
I think so, yes.
Okay. You can't just take a little five-minute nap in your office?
Right.
I mean,
or wait until after the procedure is
over? How long do the needles stay in normally?
I don't know. I've never had acupuncture.
Yeah, maybe. Not that long, probably.
Right, you, not 2 hours, I don't
you
think.
How do you pronounce it?
Acupuncture? How do you say it?
Acupuncture.
Okay.
You sure. Say acu, I say acu.
There you go.
I don't know if I've ever heard it pronounced that way.
I don't know. I'm probably wrong.
Are you? No, I'm not saying you're wrong.
No, I probably am.
I'm not.
It's not a word I use a lot.
I'm not pooping on your party over
you're
here.
You're probably right. We're just saying we don't
maybe
know.
Maybe you're right and I'm wrong. I'm just
What's
saying.
What's the country of origin for that?
Could you use it in a sentence?
You
just did.
Right.
I'm
just saying it's very unique. I've never heard it called that. It sounds very hoity-toity.
Yeah.
Oh, my wife and I were having
acupuncture.
Yes. And an Oklahoma family had no idea that a birthday gift for their 9-year-old son would lead to the birth of 50 octopus babies, numerous water tanks that took over half of a bathroom, and thousands of dollars on food supplies and water damage repairs.
Pardon? They thought it was a boy. This story is great. They
Cameron Clifford said his son Cal had been obsessed with octopuses since he was just 3 years old. Every birthday he would say, all I want is an octopus. Well, Dad finally broke down, went to a local aquarium store, and bought an octopus for Cal's 9th birthday.
I didn't know you could get octopus at the aquarium.
I didn't either. The octopus named Terrence soon began laying eggs.
Not a Terrence.
Yeah, it was a female. They documented the journey on TikTok, where his videos amassed millions of views.
Are octopi one of those things that could be male or female?
I don't know.
Where they can change if they are in distress or something like that?
Nope. I don't know.
But they lay the eggs, and then oftentimes they don't survive. Isn't that right, Shaw?
I think so, yeah.
Well, these
people had no idea they were going to have 50 octopus.
Are they like salmon, where they lay the eggs, and then they have to get fertilized?
I don't know.
By the male? So they're already pre...
But the dad said, do not get a pet octopus unless you're ready to lose sleep and your kids' college fund simultaneously. Clifford ended up ordering a saltwater tank, a water cycling system, and food supplies for Terrence. But what the family didn't realize was that Terrence was a female who started releasing little eggs 2 months after it arrived. Terrence, the octopus, ended up hatching a total of 50 babies. The family had to arrange 50 separated homes for the unexpected offspring.
Because they can't keep them in there.
Apparently
together.
They can't stay together.
They get sucked up into the filtration system because they're so tiny. So that's they have to
flush
get them out
of the toilet.
No, they're octopus. So what'd they do?
It's just a fish.
Now the desperate father is calling on aquariums and research facilities, begging them to take all these babies off of his hands. He said, we hope to rehome as many as we can.
Octopus. I think the world will be okay if you flush a bunch of them down the toilet, Shaw.
Well, they're just trying to find places that might want them or give them homes before they just do that. They're just saying, hey, is this something that your aquarium is interested in? They're like this big, and they have the little legs and everything.
So you flush them. They'll be fine. Flush them all at once.
Don't look them.
Keep the one and get rid of the rest.
Problem solved.
It's a big deal. Wait till they get a little bigger and have calamari night. He got his wish, though.
He did.
Acupuncture, huh?
Acupuncture.
I'm going to practice
that.
I'm not saying you're right.
I'm not trying to be negative. I don't want you to...
it's fine.
Never heard it pronounced like that.
It's French.
How do you say...
You Googling it?
Yeah.
What does it say?
Here. I don't know if I can. I probably have to do an ad first before it'll tell me how to say it. I don't know.
Bad news, happy music. Thank you, Shaw. Yeah. Appreciate it. Talk to you tomorrow. Acupuncture.
Acupuncture. We're right.
Acupuncture. He's saying acu. We're saying acu. That doesn't sound right.
Acupuncture.
I'm saying acupuncture.
Acupuncture.
I don't think it's acu. I think it's acu. Like, they don't go AccuWeather. Like, when they do AccuWeather on the television, it's AccuWeather. It's ACCU. Acupuncture's ACU, right?
I'm the internet. I'm just telling you what the internet's saying.
Well, the internet's wrong. I'm calling it on this one.
Rock Mornings. Monday to Friday, 6 to 9. Call.
Hello.
Email.
I tried emailing you.
Text. So many ways to check in with us.
Check.
We rely on you guys for traffic updates, requests, and all sorts of other stuff.
Check this out.
Visit rockmornings.com to get in touch with us. You can listen to the program on the website, rockmornings.com. You can check out our daily podcast in case you missed something.
I think it is acupuncture, by the way. I think we're right.
I don't think he's wrong. I'm not saying
he's wrong. I'm just saying it sounds like that's how it's being said. Acupuncture.
Our buddy Black Nick texted in, said, it's like Arnold Schwarzenegger in the State Farm commercial. It's Neba. That's what I said. Neba. Get to the chopper. Mike texted in, said, octopus can store sperm until they are ready to finish the process.
Awesome.
So the female takes the sperm, puts it in like a little sperm purse, holds on to it until she's ready, and then does the whole DNA mixture thing with the eggs, and then unleashes the fury.
When Terrence got to the house and got in her new tank, she was like, "This is it. This is where this is gonna happen."
I feel comfortable. I'm in a safe environment.
I think they're going to take care of my babies. They're not going to eat them and have a calamari night like Brian. They would take care of them and try to find
them. Oh, I'm not
homes.
Even getting that far. I'm flushing.
There are places that may take these babies.
Not wasting my time. You know what works a lot faster?
Stop.
Flushy McFlusherson. Thank you, Mike, for the expert information about octopi. Got a text from Cheryl on the Rock Line. She said, I've never had a Big Mac either. Today's the day.
Today is the day. It's McDonald's Day.
National McDonald's Day. Today, Shaw has his moped out.
Pickles, onions, and sweet bun.
Two all-beef patty special sauce, lettuce, cheese, pickles, onions, on a sesame seed bun. Is it the sesame seed? No, because they got that on the burger that he likes, right? He likes a quarter pounder with cheese.
But they have it on the Big Mac.
That's what I'm saying. I didn't know if maybe it was
the same bun, I think.
That's what I'm saying.
He's having different ingredients. I think if he just says he's not a big fan of Thousand Island, which is similar to
the special
sauce.
That's the point of the Big Mac.
If he just said light, though, I think your suggestion was good. Have him just say, I'll take that with a little light.
I don't think they overdose it. I've had plenty of Big Macs. I don't ever feel like I've had one where it's too much.
He just needs to try it. He's a man of one thing, right? He goes there, he is.
I wonder why Cheryl's never done the Big Mac. Is it a Thousand Island? Boy, I tell you what, speaking of Thousand Island, I can't remember the name of the salad dressing, but I normally, you know, Thousand Island, you get it, it's like, you know, if you get the Kraft or whatever, mm-hmm. it's orange, it's got the little chunks mm-hmm. in it, whatever.
You had a fancy one.
I don't know what the hell I did wrong, but I was like, because we were doing Reuben's around St. Patty's Day.
And
I got a different one. I got one in a glass jar, right? One of the glass bottles.
A fancy one.
Yeah, the one on the top shelf as opposed to the one that's eye level.
Sure, right.
Boy, did I F up. That was a huge mistake. That Thousand Island dressing is ass. It is the worst salad dressing I've ever had. I don't even know if I have it any left. I think I dumped it out. But if I have it, I'll bring it in here. I don't know if you're like considered an expert on Thousand Island, but you can tell me right away. This thing, I tried it so many different things in this too. Like, because, you know, we only had corned beef left over for so long. So now I tried it in the salad. Gross. Tried dipping stuff in it. Gross. So gross, so nasty. But I'm fighting the good fight. I'm not gonna throw this stupid Thousand Island dressing away that I paid too much for. Yes,
it's very hip in glass jar Thousand Island.
Well, they have a honey mustard that's really good that I almost always use on my salad if I have a. And I thought maybe this one is comparison, you know, be good. No, massive failure. It's like somebody over there didn't realize what Thousand Island dressing is supposed to taste like. It's like they got the guy on the first day to make the recipe for the Thousand Island dressing.
Yeah. Yeah, here's where this.
Oh, it's like watery and gross. It's disgusting. What the hell I was thinking. Thank you for checking in. Appreciate it. It's always good to talk to you guys. We'll holler at you tomorrow.